Are you thinking about delaying your purchase of your home? Well, then think again, because there is a definite cost of waiting to purchase a home. Hello, I'm John Thomas with Primary Residential Mortgage, and I'm going to take a minute to take you through a whole analysis of a cost of waiting to purchase a home. There are some significant financial advantages to owning a home for generating long-term wealth versus being a renter or living with family. So what we want to do is break down those costs, and the reason why is mortgage interest rates and home prices are expected to continue to rise. So if you delay purchasing a home even 6 months, it could cost you thousands of dollars. So what we're going to do now is walk you through some analysis to show you the benefits of buying now versus delaying. Okay, what we want to do is look at purchasing a home with an FHA loan with a purchase price of $225,000 with a first-time home buyer. So I'm going to take you through that analysis. So if you look, purchase property value today would be what you're buying at for $225,000. You're going to put down 3.5%, so your loan amount would be $217,125. The down payment is $7,875. That's important to know because that's part of your investment into this asset, which is going to generate long-term wealth for you over time. So let's say the interest rate today is 5%. Now you can see if you wait 6 months, rates could be 5.5%. And for a year and 2 years, I just kept it at 5.5%. 3 years, I took it up to 5.625%, just to show you a cost of interest rates going up. Now, they could go up more than that, but I just want to show you that even a small increase, there's going to be a cost of waiting. So you're going to have mortgage insurance with the FHA. Your total cash to close is going to be that down payment plus all your closing costs. We're at about $18,558. Now, your monthly principal and interest on this property is $1,166. When we add in your principal, your property tax, and your homeowner's insurance, you're at $1,505 for your mortgage payment. Now, if delaying that 6 months, your payment's $1,589. Delaying it 1 year, your payment's $1,607. And if you go out to 3 years, look, your payment is up to $1,734. So if we take a look at this analysis of cost of waiting, you can see that you're going to have a cost because of your increased interest rate on the mortgage, and you're going to have a cost because the home price is going up each month. So we use the home price appreciation of 2.31% over the 1 year period, which is the projected for Delaware for next year. So that put the property value at $230,197. So your cost of just waiting 1 year is $8,401. Now your cost just waiting 6 months is $4,166 of lost home price appreciation and an increase in your monthly mortgage payment. So there, you definitely want to think about if you can buy now, getting out there buying now versus delaying that because of that cost to purchase. Now, if we take a look at your total cost over 3 years, it's $31,533 between the amortization lost and the appreciation lost on the purchase price there. So one of the things you got to realize is I get the question, I'm not sure if I want a mortgage payment or not, but that's the wrong question to be asking. The real question is, whose mortgage do you want to pay? Do you want to pay your mortgage, or do you want to pay your landlord's mortgage, where you're paying off their investment and putting money in their pocket? Or do you want to pay off your mortgage and get the price appreciation on the home and invest your money in long-term wealth? Now, if we look at how much renting is going to cost you, because this is a good analysis, if you were to keep renting versus buying, we take a look at a renter who's going to start off with a $1,500 a month rent payment, and we'll use a 3% annual increase. Well, you're going to pay $18,000 in the first year of rent, and then your payment goes up to $1,545 in the second year, and you're at $18,450. At the end of the fifth year, you're paying $1,688, and your total rent per year is $20,256. If you take all of those and add those all up over the whole 5 years, you would have spent $95,466 on rent. Now, what do you have to show for that? Well, pretty much absolutely nothing. You don't own a property. Any repairs or maintenance you did, you don't get that back. When you move out, you no longer even have a place to live. And you've lost all that home price appreciation, you lost all those checks you wrote, they pretty much went to nothing at the end of the 5 years. So it's not a great idea to keep renting, especially in the same spot and paying off someone else's mortgage, $100,000 almost, where that could have been going toward your mortgage. Now, one other thing I want you to consider is when you're purchasing a home, you're investing money in that asset. The asset is your home. So you do want to know, what's my rate of return on that money? So the money you're investing is your down payment, which in this case on an FHA loan, 3.5%, plus whatever your closing costs are going to be. That is your investment into this asset. So over the first year, your rate of return is going to be negative if you look on the screen. But in the second year, we're negative. So we get a positive return after the first year of $1,582. But on your total investment, that's a 20% return because that's your money back after paying your closing costs. And then if you look where you're at the end of 5 years, you've netted, after taking out the closing costs back out of your appreciation, $33,235. Now, if we look at what is your actual rate of return on that investment, you can see that after 1 year, we're at 20% rate of return. 5 years, it's a 422% rate of return. I don't know where you're gonna get that rate of return on an investment. And this was based off of an annual appreciation rate of next year of 2.31% on the property 225 that you're buying. So you gotta look at, when you're investing your money, what's your rate of return? That's an insane amount of rate of return on your money, and that's one of the best reasons to get out there and purchase a home now, because the longer you wait, the more you delay that rate of return on your money, because when you're paying money towards rent, you're not getting any rate of return on that money. So don't wait, get out there, get out shopping for a home, get pre-approved, get under contract. Now, if you need help with a pre-approval or you got questions, give us a call in the office, 302-703-0727, or you can go online, DelawareMortgageLoans.net, get tons of information. If you just want to go ahead and start that loan application, PRMILoanApplication.com. My team and I would love to take great care of you.